Well, welcome back. Boy racers get a bad rep, but is it their fault alone? Should their cars be crushed, or should parents and authorities take a look at how we can help? I'm joined by Assistant Commissioner of Police Operations Viv Rickard, team coach Daryl Gardner, and welcome to the Good Morning Whānau, Eva Maria. Thank you so much for coming on the show. It's a topic that's probably been talked about quite a lot in the media over the past few months. Viv, what are the issues that we have, or what are we facing?
Well, I think firstly we get it wrong. We think it's just about activity on the road. If you talk to most New Zealanders, there's a couple of issues for them. Number one, it's the noise. Mm-hmm. So, all the wheelies, the loud exhausts, it's a real problem for a lot of New Zealanders. Mm. Now, I spend a lot of time policing out in districts, and I talk to communities, groups all the time. The number one, two or three issues are around graffiti, in speech marks, boy races, as they termed it. So there's a whole range of issues with it.
So how are we dealing with it? Because, I mean, I've read in the past with the council in Taupo that they provide a place for these boy racers so they can, you know, like a controlled environment. Yeah. Is that going to help?
Oh, look, it's great that people want to do some other things. I think that certainly can contribute towards it. But illegal street racing or boy races has been going for over 30 years in
right.
New Zealand. Okay, so I don't think there's a panacea in terms of it. It's about managing the problem, about understanding why people are doing certain things. Now, people are getting together with their friends, driving around town. I've got no issues with that. It's when they start interfering with other people's space, threatening and intimidating them. There are two or three distinct groups. There's the car enthusiasts.
Right.
Okay, so they're the people that have been going for years that
yeah.
just love V8s or the new cars.
Mm-hmm.
And on the other side, you've actually got a little bit of a criminal element. Okay, and they're only a small percentage of them. They are people, you know, that probably cause a lot of the problems. So from New Zealanders' point of view, when the older you get, I guess you get, you know, you feel like it shouldn't be happening, but
mm-hmm.
it's been going for a long time.
Right.
And it's just about making sure that we try and manage the problem.
Eva, you're a little bit younger than us on the panel, and you probably rub shoulders with maybe some of these types of people that are car or boy racers. What are your thoughts and feelings of what's happening, and why are they doing it?
Well, I think for one thing, teenagers, they don't really have much to do. Like, if you think about it, and they say that there's a huge percentage of boy racers in Christchurch, and I was in Christchurch last year, it's flat. And okay, honestly, if you put yourself in a 17-year-old's shoes, what would you do there?
Mm.
Like, Christchurch is a beautiful city. Like, you've got the gardens, you've got the shopping, but if a teenager doesn't have like heaps of money to go and buy Gucci, what are they gonna do? And then at the same time, I mean, we're teenagers and we're allowed to have our driver's licenses
mm-hmm.
when we're 15, and we want to go out there and drive, because like in movies they show adults like speeding off into the sunset or something, you know,
yeah.
and it's cool, you
yeah.
know, it's prestige. So why can't we do that? And we want to do that as well, you know?
The interesting thing though is we talk about a recession, and we talked about how petrol prices were hiked and things like that. Viv, I mean, there's a money issue. Where are they getting the money to sort of feed their cars with petrol, and also with the tyres? They're burning up that much rubber. Where does it all come from?
Yeah, it's a good question. I think part of it, we need to start thinking about parenting. That's a lot of people are providing, particularly for the younger people that have got cars, they're getting a lot of money from their parents. There are, you know, we should remember as well that boy racers, we're talking about people in their 20s as well,
yeah.
that are working, that have jobs, that this is their, as Eva's talked about, that this is their Friday night out. Whereas, a lot of New Zealanders growing up went to play sport and did other things, and found things to do. So the money issue is something for us about where they're getting the money from. The people that we're catching are getting significant fines.
Mm.
Their cars have been taken, and that's still not stopping some of them, the hardcore numbers.
It's interesting you say fines. We asked at the start of the show whether people could send emails, and I'm going to read this email. It says, Dear Good Morning, the way I see it, one potential solution to the boy racer problem is treat fines over $1,500 or a similar amount as bad debt after 6 months, and non-payment means a bad credit rating. This would mean that they cannot just get another car on finance, breaking the cycle of easy-to-get high-powered cars with idiots behind the wheel. That's from Jesse in Christchurch. That's a government issue, really, more than anything, isn't it?
Yeah, look, firstly, I don't think we should knee-jerk around what the actual issues are. We can go put in a whole lot of... There needs to be, for some people, some quite hard-lined approach, but let me go back to what I said. A lot of the people are OK, but it's the issue around that noise. Now, There is an issue for us in government in respect of the current legislation we have around the control of these types of vehicles. Other countries, they do have a different approach in terms of, say, third-party insurance. In Australia, you'll notice some differences that you have to be quite wealthy to drive around on a souped-up car because of the insurance. It's actually twice as much as the vehicle, and for most places, they won't insure you. So there are those types of approaches. But once again, I think we need to understand what the problem is before jumping in.
Right. Darren, what are your thoughts about what's going on?
I just agree with what you're saying. I don't think the term boy racer is helpful because, number one, a lot of them aren't boys. You know, these are not high schoolers. A lot of them are males in their 20s. And most young people I know who have some sort of souped-up car are actually pretty responsible, having a good time. There's a small core element who cause totally do inappropriate things, like the one we heard about in Christchurch of shooting a slug gun at the police officer in Sarandon. That's totally inappropriate. Boy racing is not the issue there. Whoever did that needs to be dealt with, and I think live with the consequence of their action. Let's not brand everybody with the same approach. I think we actually, as a society, have to go back a step as well and say, risky behaviour is, I think, a normal part of growing up.
Yeah.
These days, we tend to, I think, to wrap our young people in so much cotton wool, there's very little risks they can take. They're legal. You can't even play rugby in some high schools at lunchtime in case you're injured and there's all sorts of investigations. So, I mean, I think we're going to find, if we're not careful, risky behaviour increasing in illegal activities because that's often almost the only way a lot of young men and young women can experience it.
From a police perspective, I mean, we look at that situation. Has that happened in the past? But I guess now it's just come out in the media that, you know, what actually happened, the actions that happened. How do you approach a situation like that? I mean, he's by himself, because you're getting a message from the boy racers saying that he provoked them.
Yeah. Well, look, these 300 boy racers, one policeman turns up in the car. So who do you think is in terms of the power, you know, in the area of strength? They're very organised, our boy racers, in terms of texting, and they all get together. Look, you've got 300 people with around 180 cars in a train going around Christchurch. That's interfering with everyone else's space. So whilst on one part I'm saying let's not knee-jerk around it, there are some significant issues around what they're actually doing. So they are organised, and they are intimidating some people. And I think New Zealanders should be able to go around New Zealand and actually enjoy the great country that we have.
Fantastic. Viv, Eva, Daryl, thank you so much for coming in. Well, we could have talked for a lot longer, but it's a pleasure to have you on the show. Thank you so much for that.
Thank you.